Okay, so I had a couple questions for you because this is all so exciting for me. I've been such a fan of yours for so long, and I look up to you in so many ways. And so I want to know, like, what about Better By Myself resonated with you when you heard it for the first time, and how do you take care of yourself? Like, how do you practice self-love and self-care?
When I first heard the song, it was really empowering and inspiring because I think for myself and many others, we can get caught up in the fantasy of looking for our happiness or our fulfillment in someone else. And I think that we don't recognize the power that we're giving away, in a sense. And I think when you hear the song, you're like, oh, wait a minute, that power is mine and I complete myself. And for me, it's the place of me as a complete individual. Whenever, whoever someone else is, it's I'm complete here by myself already. And so if you come, you're a wonderful accoutrement, but honey, we don't need it. You know what I mean? That's what I feel. That's what I feel. So yeah.
To all of like the young kids, the teenagers who are a fan of you, Monique Hart and Kevin, in and out of drag, what do you have to say to them in terms of, you know, how to practice self-confidence, how to practice self-love? What is your message to them?
I think confidence is something that you learn, and I'm gonna tell those to learn it early on, so that way you're not learning to find confidence later on in life. I would say wherever you find strength in, whether it's your art, your creativity, you may be the life of the party, the very blunt, vocal one in the room, just own it and find strength in that place. And then when you feel yourself wanting to shrink back because you feel that what you are, who you are, or what you bring to the table is not enough as what someone else is bringing, chop that down, throw that out, and then put a little bit of extra sass on what you bring, because what you bring is enough, and to always remember that. And so that's what I would say. Like, drag for me, you know, some people find confidence in drag. I would say what drag helped me do was to put that little bit of extra sass, that extra little sauce, that extra little juice onto the confidence that I had to. So we're always growing, we're always changing. And just to let these hoes eat, like, for all the children out there, like, don't let nobody make you feel less than. Always stand 10 toes down. Even if you don't fully know or how to fully express who you feel, what you feel, just stand 10 toes down and say, bitch, I'm figuring it out. But as of right now, it is what it is. I said what I said. Now, good day. I'm going
to fly. You are iconic and beautiful and lovely. And just thank you so much again for being a part of this. It's so exciting.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.